Very good evening, students. Here we are present with a knowledge series session for especially the students of graduate or postgraduates. Those are learning historical prospects in Indian culture. In this context, today I am going to deliver a session onto a very important topic of Indian history, rather the ancient Indian history, that is India's Valley Civilization. So this lecture may be an important session for any age group, maybe the graduates or postgraduates or the students of different capacities. Those are learning Indian history for various competitive exams, including civil services and the other competitive exams in the trade of Indian history, maybe UGC NET also. So without any delay, let us proceed with this topic. Today the discussion will be based upon the Indus Valley Civilization. I guess I shall try to give you the presentation, and with the help of few presentations I shall be able to complete this particular topic. Hope my screen is visible to you all. As far as Indus Valley Civilization is concerned, first of all we need to understand how does this name came as Indus Valley Civilization. We need to understand Indus is actually the river valley by which the name of this particular civilization came across. Now there are different scholars and experts, those have stated about the opinion. They had stated that Indus Valley Civilization is actually the word which is given by the Greek people to this particular country, because of they know that something is beyond than that of Hindu Kush Parbatmala or the mountain ranges related to Hindu Kush. So they have by default pronounced Hindu by Indus, because their pronunciation was not ratified at that time. So it is by default Hindu or Indus, because they have got certain problems with their speaking of that particular word. So they have got an interpretation of word Hindu, and therefore the word comes into the existence that most of the scholars and most of the historians are believing in. So the name of the civilization named on Indus Valley Civilization by the name of this particular event. I guess majority of the experts are agreed upon that this particular civilization dates back somewhere around 2500 BCE, right? So this is particular a time frame which is somewhere around 5000 or 4000 plus years back at our history time. So this is what one of the important aspect that we are covering here, and it is an important time frame for the students those are learning Indian history. Now let us talk about what all are the roots of Indus Valley Civilization. When we concentrate about the South Asia, and we can narrate this particular diagram of Indian the subcontinent, we find especially Indian subcontinent, if I am talking Indian subcontinent to be considered today's Indian subcontinent. On the contrary, when this valley civilization was framed, it was a time frame where we were talking about an area related to mainland of Indus River, related to Afghanistan, Pakistan and India. Nowadays there it was a time frame where the people have got the incident approach of life towards the river valley called Indus. There are many important sites, those are there, mainly Mohenjo-daro, Harappa, then Ropat, Kali Bengal, and so many other sites like Lothal. There are many sites in this river valley civilization which are predominantly there in the state of Pakistan. So of course this is a civilization which was dates back somewhere around 2500 BC, and this is one of the very richest civilization as far as man history is concerned. If we talk about this civilization, it is the earliest civilization of Indus Valley was discovered by in the year of 1857 when railroad was supposed to be crewed into that particular section. At the time of British India, they were trying to dig out a railway work related project. Then incidentally, this particular project, this particular civilization was digged out by them. So this was an important aspect. There are many cities which are important cities as far as this particular civilization is concerned. So we need to consider and we need to understand that it is one of the important segment in this particular civilization, mainly Harappa, Mohenjo-Daro. Harappa is a city civilization, city under that civilization, and it is known as urban civilization also because urbanization was at the peak. Mohenjo-Daro is Mohenjo-Daro Dara or Hills Deed was the area which was far flung updated or hilly area. Both cities shared urban design and architectural features. There are different types of artifact being found in those areas, and architectural marbles had stated this civilization have got the standards of different reputation. So this is what one of the important aspects. The 3 miles of circumference were reported and approximate with the population of 40,000 people at that particular city. So we are talking about, and this is purely on the basis of the assumption of the given by historians, stated by through the record and or references of my PPT. As far as this particular area is concerned, the people have got the trade contacts through this Silk Route. Khyber Pass is the route through Iran plateau and Ethiopia via Mediterranean Sea. So this is that was a route. Another route which is related or well connected with the Indus Valley, Indus River, that is connected through the Persia Gulf, and it is closely associated with the way of Bengal. And now we can understand by the significance of trade routes here that there is a well connected commitment being witnessed by these civilization people. That meant for they were very good traders. It's not like that the people, those are coming to their people, their countryside. That meant for they are good traders, they are good sailors, they have got the information system by which they can communicate each other. Now information system doesn't mean the information system like nowadays. They have the communication process, they have the bilateral trade, they have got the education system, administrative system. There should be a port sort of system to communicate here and there. So this should be an approximation by which their scientific expertise can be showcased. So in total, after evaluating all these civilizations, Egyptian civilization is well connected with this particular civilization. Let me take a different color so that we can put it impression on that. Egypt have got a wonderful connection with our civilization. Mesopotamia have also wonderful connection and routes, and trade routes are being one of the important trade routes in the world history. So this is what one of the important aspect for the learners, those are doing the competitive exams. Many of the time this may be asked that do we have these significant trade relations? Yes, we do have. What all are the trade routes? And this is one of the key trade routes.